Welcome to Life in the God Lane. My name's Tom West, and this is a verse for the day for Monday, the 15th of November, 2021. I'm going to explain to you what I'm going to do. I am going to spend the next 14 days going through the 34th Psalm, and I'm going to call this How to Recover from Anything, written by David, the King of Israel, who had been a little bit of everything. He'd been a shepherd, he'd been a soldier, and he'd been the king of Israel, made a lot of mistakes. He had to recover from all kinds of things. He had to recover from animals trying to get his sheep, and he had to kill them, okay? The very first day he was a soldier, he had to recover from going against the biggest, baddest soldier the world had ever known, you know? And he took him down with a stone and a slingshot. He had to overcome the loss of people he loved over and over again. He had to overcome his own sin. He had to overcome a king running around trying to kill him. He had to overcome his son taking over his kingdom and then his son dying when he lost the battle. He had to recover from all kinds of things. Guess what? You and I have to recover from all kinds of things. And it starts with Psalm 34, verse 1. He says, I will extol the Lord at all times. In other words, at all times of life, he will extol the Lord. That means that he was involved in extreme praise and glorification and worship of the Lord at all times in his life. Bad times, good times, all times. He was extolling the Lord. And then he says this, his praise will always be on my lips. When things are bad, you praise the Lord. Praise him for the victory that's coming. When things are good, you praise the Lord. You spend your life praising the Lord. I wish that I had learned this lesson 50 years ago. It's important. I know it today, and I'm grateful that I know it today. But you live your life extolling the Lord at all times and with his praise on your lips at all times. Remember something else about King David. He was a praise musician. He was a praise musician. He was a professional praiser. You and I need to be professional praisers. That's how we set the stage to recover from anything. Live in the midst of praise, being offered to God at all times. You know what happens? He inhabits his praise. He inhabits his praise. He lives in his praise. And you win when you praise. By the way, I'm wearing a new hat. This is the Firebirds. It's my grandson's baseball team. He's on a baseball team, and that's the hat that he wears. They gave me one. That's cool. I will see you tomorrow.